Hello and welcome to QuickerSim CFD Toolbox tutorial number 27. In this tutorial, we will be discussing the shallow water solver available in the toolbox. Now, the shallow water equations are a set of equations that are used to simplify three-dimensional flow into two-dimensional flow when one of the dimensions is very small or negligible compared to the others. This is the case, for example, in a bathtub filled with water or in an ocean where this seems paradoxical because obviously oceans are not shallow. However, their depth is very small compared to their remaining two dimensions. Now, the equations are visible on your screen here. H is the unknown field that we will be solving for. It is the height of the water or the fluid. And it is a field that depends on two variables. In this case, let us say X and Y. Next, T is, of course, time. We are differentiating with regards to time. H is a constant. It is the mean height or depth of the water for the entire problem. U is the velocity vector. It is in bold. It is a vector. Next, here we have, once again, velocity and time. F is a constant connected to the Coriolis force. This matrix is simply a constant. G is the gravitational constant, and B is also a constant connected with viscous forces. Now, literature on the subject of shallow water is available readily online if you would like to learn more. So let us go into the code now. Here, first, of course, we need to read and display the mesh. As you can see, it is a rather simple geometry. These walls are all non-penetration boundaries, so the water will flow along these walls. Let us close this for now. Next, as you can see here, we are defining the problem parameters in the structure SWE. These directly correspond to the constants you can see in these equations. They're named exactly the same. Here we have the time step and number of time iterations. Next, we are defining the initial height field and initial velocity field. As you can see, the initial velocities are set to zero, and you will see the initial height in a second. So here inside the main iterative loop, of course, as is the case with all of the QuickerSim CFD toolbox solvers, we have to assemble the stiffness matrix, which is done here. Next, we impose boundary conditions, and then we simply solve this problem. Thus, we achieve the height and also the velocities. And next, we are simply plotting the solution. Here you can see this is a inbuilt MATLAB function that will display the solution. Its documentation is also available in MATLAB. An important note here is you may want to limit your z-axis just so it doesn't rescale at every iteration. It will simply perhaps be beneficial visually. Also, if you would like to see simply a color map of your problem, you can uncomment this line of code. I am leaving it commented, and you will see that we will get an isometric view of the solution. These lines right here and here at the end, and also there was one line before, they're commented right now. They're simply here if you wish to make a video of your solution. You should uncomment these lines. Now, let us start the solver. Now, as you can see, this is the initial solution. Here we have larger height in the middle of the problem, and it will gradually spread out. Now, I have solved this earlier, and I have prepared a video of this solution since it will take a bit of time to actually solve on your screen. So I will now pause the execution of this program, and I will simply show you the video. So once again, this is the initial solution, and here we go. As you can see, the water rebounds off the walls and converges back towards the middle. Great. Thank you. This was the end of tutorial number 27. For more information, visit our website at quickersim.com. Also, be sure to check out our YouTube channel and Facebook page for more tutorials and up-to-date news. Thank you for listening, and goodbye.